Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Keyport Central School. Keyport High School Drama Club proudly presents its 19th theatrical production. Before we begin, in the event of an emergency, please be aware of the exit doors to your left and your right. Recordings and photography during the show are strictly prohibited. We do have professionals here this evening. We also ask that your cell phones are turned off or silenced, as it is a distraction to the performers and others around you. There is one 15-minute intermission at the end of Act 1. Please visit the snack tables for a refreshing root beer float, cupcake, or other treat generously donated by our very own Parents of Drama Club. Tonight, we have a special senior night at the end of our show if you would like to stay and enjoy honoring our seniors who are graduating. And now we take you to 1957 for our musical production of Bye Bye Birdie.
Huh? I just dropped in to say goodbye, Albert, darling. Lots of luck.
Oh, Rosie, you can't. Not today of all days. My pills. Where are my pills? Little white ones I take when I'm overwrought.
Here.
Not so much. Break it in half?
You're 33 years old, Albert. You can take a whole aspirin.
I am not 33. I'm a long way from 33. I won't be 33 until tomorrow. Water?
It's no use, Albert. My mind's made up. I've been with Alma Lou 8 years now, and as well as you know, I've been a lot more than a secretary to you.
Rose, those were mere moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness and the office, I've put a good 90-hour work week. And for what? A 50-cent pay raise in 1954 and a bottle of Arpeggi last Christmas?
Promise her anything but give her Arpeggi. Rosie!
But not even a 16th of an ounce! Besides, I want something more than that.
If you're referring to anything of a more permanent nature between you and I, I'm not ready for it. Besides, there are religious differences.
Spanish is not a religion.
And if it's part of the company you're after, the answer is no to that too. Aunt Lou is me, Mama Lou. And any change in that would kill the poor woman for me.
Nothing could kill your mother, Albert, except maybe a silver bullet.
And I don't trust Lou either. He loved you, Rose.
I love Lou too. Sure, he was warm, he was loyal, he was lovable. But he died 6 years ago. And besides, he was a wired-haired terrier. It's not the company I'm after. It's something much more than that.
Rose, if you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I am in no mood to discuss it.
There's nothing to discuss, Albert. Conrad Birdie's going into the army. I quit. There's nothing you can do but go back to college and get your...
Rosie, I'm up to my ears in debt. Conrad Birdie's got a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay. And I've just taken a sphere for this aspirin.
Albert, this may be your last chance. Will you listen to me, Albert? I'm serious. He's going in the army is the best thing he can do. Now you're free to start to do what you wanted to. Albert, Albert. It would just be 4 years, but it's 8 years, Albert. 8 more years, Albert.
It takes time to build a business.
It was only a sideline, that's what you said. You just needed some money, that's what you said. You're going to college and get ahead. Instead of being a music business bum, we're going to NYU and become...
Don't say it, Rose.
English teacher!
Rosie.
And furthermore, he wrote poetry.
Please don't.
And in NYU yearbook of 1952 under Albert Peterson's favorite piece of literature, do you know what it says? Little Women.
I'm ruined in show business.
An English teacher, an English teacher, if only in an English teacher.
Mrs. Allen!
help me raise the rest of the money to pay off Conrad's guarantee. And as soon as we're out of the red, I'll dissolve the company and go back to the academic life.
Albert, you're on!
Of course, it could take a few years, but by 1974, 75 at the latest will... What's that?
Something that's gonna push that date up a few years. Pick a name.
Pick what name? What's going on?
Right, I'll pick it for you. McAfee, Kim McAfee, age 15, president and recording secretary of Conrad Birdie Fan Club number 2748 of Sweet Apple, Ohio. Mary, would you give me a Sweet Apple? Yes, the number is 78820, and call me right back.
Who's Kim? Whatever her name is.
Kim McAfee, Albert. It's what's going to send you back to college with the biggest hit business, the biggest hit song this business has ever seen. It's called One Last Kiss.
I never heard of it.
You haven't written it yet, but when you do, and when that one last kiss is from Conrad Birdie on his way to the big cold army for 2 long years, and when that one last kiss is placed on one of his fans, chosen at random from 4,200,000, is staggering the teenagers, will make Mr. Birdie the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
Rose, I'm beginning to see it. Got the record here in New York.
Take that greasy bongo playing car thief to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
And release the record. Albert, you'll have enough money to stay in college for the rest of your life.
Rose, that'll be perfect. And I promise you, as soon as this is all figured out, it'll be just the two of us, in perfect bliss. I'll be teaching English and you. Wait, that rhymes. Bliss, kiss. What if anyone's ever used it before? What difference does it make? It'll be perfect for the song. Oh, one last kiss. It gives so much bliss. What is your dentifrice? No, that's too clinical.
An English teacher, an English teacher. Someday he may be an English teacher. Mary? Yes, well, every woman's Sweet Apple can't be busy. What's going on there? Kim McAfee just got pinned by Hugo and... Never mind. Keep trying and call me right back. It could have been such a wonderful life. I could have been Mrs. Peterson. Mrs. Albert Peterson. Mrs. Byfield and Kappa Peterson. The English teacher's
life. mountain as girls gather to worship that wonderful creature. Do you realize what you'd be giving up, Kim?
I'm sorry, Ursula, but my mind's made up. First, I'll still listen to these records, but things like the Conrad Bury scream and the fudge, they're past me now.
You mean you're giving up the scream? When Conrad Bury sings on television, you're not going to go, ah!
Oh, Kim.
Kim, dear, would you please get off the phone? I've got some calls to make.
All right, Mother. I'm sorry, Ursula. I've got to go. You'll explain everything to the other kids, won't you?
I suppose I'll have to. Bye, Kim. Kim, are you sure? I mean, after all, Kim, are you absolutely sure?
Positive. After all, I'm 15 years old and it's time I'd settle in.
Kiss me!
quit smoking until you're 15. Shall we?
Thank you.
Oh boy, would you get that stuff down at track 12 on the double? Rosie, what are you doing?
Getting our luggage down from the station without any help from you, Albert.
I don't suppose a generous tip would make things up.
Albert, just take your briefcase and go down to that train station before any of those reporters talk to Conrad alone. You know what happened last time.
You better hang on to it, Rose. I'm waiting for Mama.
Speaking of your mother, Albert, have you told her about the dissolving Almelu?
I couldn't. Yesterday was the anniversary.
Of what?
Lou, 6 years ago, was struck on 181st Street in Broadway by a loaded beer truck.
You!
Do you suppose that's Mama?
It's either her or the all clear.
You go, Sonny boy!
Mama! What's the matter?
Don't worry, Sonny, I'm just a little faint in the subway.
Subway? I told you to take a taxi.
Taxis? What do I need with taxis? I'll leave taxis for my successful son. A mother can ride on a dirty, crowded subway full of foreign people, but wouldn't give up a seat if your life depended on it. But what's the difference? I'm only a mother, and a mother is lower than dirt nowadays anyway. Here's the money I saved from not taking a taxi. Buy some candy with it. Who's she?
Mama, this is Rose Alvarez from the office.
This is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez? I can't believe it. Ah! Rose, you had a sudden shock or something?
Albert, I think I'm gonna go see if Conrad's here.
By all means, Miss Alvarez. Look at her, Sonny. How nice she looks. It's a wonder some older man hasn't come and snatched her off yet. A personal matron with the brains and a few dollars. What a catch you'd be for a convalescent. Goodbye, Rose.
Goodbye, May.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
Well, Mama, what I was going to discuss with you was sort of about Rose. Maybe you'd better have a seat.
Why? I know my Sonny. He loves his Mama. He would never say anything that would break his Mama's heart. Go ahead, dear. What about Rose?
Well, Mama, about Lou, too.
Lou? Where are you, Lou? Struck down by the beverage I consumed faithfully for 32 years. What about Lou?
Well, Mama, it's just gross thought, and I agree that I should give up the company. What's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. You just killed me, that's all.
You don't understand. It's just gross thought. I mean, listen, here's some money. Take a cab home. The subways are too crowded.
Nothing's too crowded for a mother. I'll take the IRT. That's the worst subway. Wait a minute. How many blocks is it? Only 107? Oh, well.
Mama!
Enjoy yourself, son. Take care. Wear your heavy coat. Be careful crossing the street. Keep your money in your inside pocket. Wear your rubbers. And eat a hot lunch.
Albert, I thought you were going to bring it to her gently.
Well, as a matter of fact, Rose, I didn't tell her at all. She was so upset about my leaving, I thought I'd better wait.
You mean you didn't?
He's coming. Conrad Birdie!
Later, Rosie. Conrad's coming. Later! Post those assign me to the frontline trenches. That way I'll be sure to get one of those dirty chairs. Outward! Whoever's dirty this side.
Hey, Mr. Beavis, give us the real skin.
Conrad's still drinking a lot.
Now listen here. That gossip must stop. He goes to church each Sunday and he doesn't touch a drop.
He's as decent as a minister. He's as sober as a judge. He subscribes to every charity and his hobby's making fudge.
For he's outside of standing, patriotic, helping our American boy.
Did he truly found Conrad in the form school?
That is a lie through and through. I'll tell you where he came from. Here's the story, and it's true. He was born in Indochina, son of missionaries there.
On a 1,000-acre farm. Started singing.
We've got dirty Hong Kong
foundation food.
We love you, beautiful horses in the sky. Forever waves of rain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee. For he's a prime
Conrad Burney has one admires a far distant
unattainable ideal. When I come to you, you know, that I care about how common and ordinary you are. That's how I'm going to stay.
Not just saying that to make you feel better?
I mean every word. Conrad Birdie is just plain.
Steady is forever.
Present you with this 14-carat solid gold key. so generously donated by the men of the Sweet Apple Grass Bowl. And I present this key to you, Mr. Conrad Bird.
Ah! You said it! Ah!
What? All I've said is Conrad Bird.
Ah!
You girls, don't be quiet. I can't finish my speech.
Oh, who cares about your speech? Anyone even from Conrad?
Got being sincere.
Edna, what's the matter?
You got being sincere.
Mr. Birdie, what are you doing?
You got to feel it here, cause if you feel it here, well then you're gonna be honestly sincere.
Edna!
What you feel is true, really feel it you, make them feel it too. Write this down now, you gotta be sincere, honestly sincere, man you're gonna be. Thank you.
wrong 10,000 times, didn't we? Well, we've got 5,276 to go. So stay.
This mess, as you call it, Kim, happens to be my breakfast, and I intend to enjoy it.
Now, your father has the right to enjoy his eggs, Kim. But, maybe he wouldn't mind if we start quietly clearing away some of these other things. I know the house is so hectic this morning, but Kim's gone through a lot of trouble to prepare a special breakfast for Mr. Birdie, and I want to make sure everything is ready for him to come down. After all, he is a national figure.
Doris, I'm not budging from this room until I get my coffee, smoke a cigarette, and read my paper.
Oh, I'm sorry, dear, but I didn't have time for your coffee this morning. How about, a nice warm 7-Up?
Morning, Pop. Here's your paper. I hope you don't mind it, because these stories about Conrad.
What do you expect me to read? The obituary? I've tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I've extended the program of self-determination to both the woman I've married and the children I've desired. The vote has been denied. There's been no taxation without representation, and all open covenants have been openly arrived at. Last night, you wanna know what I did? I slept in a camp cot with my feet in the fireplace and my head in an ashtray. And then phone calls were made to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and like 7 of them were to Hong Kong. And then outside my window, 3 harpies shriek, "We love you, Conrad," 4,723 times, and I've just lost 2 fried eggs. Gentlemen, the democracy is over. The parliament has been dissolved. The Magna Carta is revoked, and Nero is back in town. And you don't offer an emperor a warm 7-Up.
Oh, Mr. McAfee, I hope you won't mind keeping off the phone. I'm waiting for a long-distance call from New York.
Perfectly all right. I'll just go to burnt Rome.
Mother?
What's wrong?
Nothing, dear. Your father's just excited. That's all.
He's coming!
He's coming!
I get the eggs. Mother, you call the kids!
Girls, he's coming. But you better hurry if you want to watch me.
Here we are, kids. Hi, Doris. Sorry, I hope you don't mind. I'll stay back in the party.
Here he is.
Call me for lunch. Hey, Fats.
Now look here, Doris, about that boy.
Oh, please, Harry, he's just shy. If you ask me.
After all, this kid is only 15, and I don't want her to...
Please, Daddy, not in front of everyone.
Ursula, we better go.
I don't care who's here. No ill-mannered loud is gonna...
Tell him, Pa!
You shut up!
Harry! You have no right to talk like that. You know it. That boys are Jesse.
This is my hatch, and until you're 18...
But, Daddy!
I said shut up until you're 18!
But, Daddy!
Will you leave me alone?
Mr. and Mrs. McAfee, Kim, Randolph, is that the way you want to be seen by 75 million Americans?
What are you talking about?
You're all going to be on TV with Conrad.
On television?
That's right. I got the confirmation from Ed Sullivan himself.
You mean we're going to be on the Sullivan Show? The Ed Sullivan Show?
That's right. That's why I beg of you to present all petty differences. To that free audience out there, you can make the American dream come true. So, for the free world's sake, Mr. Matthew, don't destroy that dream.
Me? On the Ed Sullivan Show? Ed Sullivan! Me, Harry McAfee, appearing with... Ed Sullivan!